Hello viewers, I'm Mridula and welcome back to my cookbook channel. Today in this video, I'm going to show you how to make a chocolate lava cake in pressure cooker. To make this, we are going to need 120 grams of semi-sweet chocolate. The chocolate that I am using has 50% cocoa and rest 50% is sugar. If you're using dark chocolate with more than 50% cocoa, you need to add little extra sugar in this recipe. Because darker the chocolate, the amount of sugar added is less. So, cut the bar of chocolate in small pieces so that it won't take much time to melt while cooking. Next, we need 120 grams of salted butter. As I'm using salted butter, I'm not going to add any extra salt. But if you're using unsalted butter, you need to add just a pinch of salt in this recipe. Adding salt will enhance the flavor of this cake. Next, we need 2 whole eggs and 2 egg yolks, that is 4 eggs in total. The eggs should be at room temperature, do not use them directly from refrigerator. 2 teaspoons of all-purpose flour, also known as Maida, 1 teaspoon vanilla essence and 1/4 cup powdered sugar. We also need extra butter to grease the mold and some all-purpose flour to dust in them. So first step is grease the molds with generous amount of butter. Place some all-purpose flour in the mold and spread it around so that the flour stick to the butter layer. Then turn the mold over onto the surface and tap it to get rid of any excess flour. These molds are ready. Next step is preheating. If you want to bake this cake in convection oven, then preheat the oven at 180 degrees Celsius. I'm going to bake this in pressure cooker. So to preheat the pressure cooker, place a metal stand at the base of the cooker, remove the ring and also the whistle and just place the lid on top and let the cooker heat on medium flame. Meanwhile the cooker is heating, we will make the batter. Start by melting butter and chocolate in a double boiler. To do this, take a vessel filled with little water and let the water heat on medium flame. Place a bowl over it. Into the bowl, add butter and chocolate. Keep on stirring till the chocolate is melted completely. Remove from the heat and keep it aside. Next, in a large bowl, break 2 eggs. Then separate yolks. The reason behind adding 2 extra egg yolks is that when the cake is cooked, the inside lava of this cake will get a creamy custard-like texture. Now comes the very important step, that is beating the eggs. You can use a wire whisk, it will take around 10 minutes of continuous beating, but I am going to use a hand mixer here. This will work quickly and will also give great results. We have not used any baking powder or baking soda in this recipe, so it is important to beat the eggs till they double in volume and become fluffy. This will help rise the cake. After a minute of beating, add in powdered sugar. Now you can see the eggs have doubled in volume. Now add vanilla essence and all-purpose flour and again mix till the flour has blended well with the eggs. Now add in chocolate and butter mixture. This chocolate mixture is still warm, so slowly add them and keep on mixing at the same time. Very gently mix everything together till well combined. Then pour the batter in greased mold. We need to half fill the mold with batter. Then tap the mold couple of times to release any air bubbles in it. If you're using oven, then bake this cake at 180 degrees Celsius for 6 minutes. And for pressure cooker method, place the mold inside preheated cooker. Cover the cooker with lid and cook for 6 minutes. Again, make sure you have removed the ring and whistle. We need to undercook the cake to get that creamy chocolate at the center. Even a half minute extra will completely cook this cake. Of course, the cake will be yummy, but you won't get the chocolate lava inside. Also, the time will differ from the size of the mold. For me, it took 6 minutes, but if you're using smaller mold, then it might take around 5 minutes. After 6 minutes of cooking, carefully take the mold out with a pair of tongs. Wait for a few seconds. We need to serve this cake while it's warm. Don't wait too long or else the inside lava will continue to cook. Quickly run a knife along the edges to loosen the cake and invert it onto plate. Give a few tap and lift the mold. The cake will come out easily. Sprinkle some powdered sugar on it and serve. Now let's see whether we have that oozing chocolate lava inside. Make this super delicious chocolate lava cake and leave your feedback in the comments below. If you like this video, then click the like button, share this video with your friends and family, and very important, subscribe to my channel. See you next time with a new recipe. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.